initially, well, according to the board, it's how social media changed my life.
No, that's not what it says.
But according to what they put up there, it's how social media dealt with my life.
That's right.
Well, changed, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
I want to know how it dealt with your life.
That got interpreted to how social media affected my life.
Oh.
That's what I thought it said.
No, I thought it was dealted.
Yeah.
No, it did, but on the website, it got changed.
On the website, they interpreted it.
Oh.
Wait, there's interwebs stuff going on.
They just changed to F. They just changed to star, 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 star.
Oh.
So.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No,
that's not the interpretation you want.
I totally messed up her life.
She calls you social media.
So I kind of gave this talk a little bit SpaceUp DC, and I kind of want to give a shout out to Jen, Chris, and Andy, and everyone that are watching down at the Decepticon headquarters where I used to live.
I'm sorry, at where?
It's
Transformers.
As in the Transformers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
Your lifestyle is much cooler than mine if you're living there.
I had a cool roommate, what can I say? But it kind of started like back when I guess I joined Twitter and NASA initially started all their cleanup business. Like I lived in Michigan, I liked space and I love space. I've always loved space. But it didn't really give me much to do, and then once I joined Twitter and met more space friends, because Michigan, they don't really care that much about space. I hate to admit it, but...
Not even at the university?
Isn't it too cold to care about space?
Yes, go blue, but Michigan State didn't really like it that much. But it kind of opened, like, Twitter opened up new opportunities for me to meet people like, say, Flying Jet, and to get an inside view into, like, the space program and things like that. And it kind of started with, like, the first launch tweet-up, which, if you ever signed up for any NASA tweet-up, stuff you do now, if you see the person holding the badge, that is my claim to fame.
All right.
Every single NASA tweet-up thing has my picture on it now, and every time they send one out, I get lots of tweets about it, and I'm like, yes, that's me, I'm a poster child. So that's how most people know me. But after going to, like, that tweet-up, and you can kind of see how they've evolved, but I was able to talk more about space and feel more like I had my own community, even though I lived in Michigan and didn't really talk about it so that much. Well, it just so happened to turn out that when I went down to 132, their second launch tweet-up, I was starting to seriously think about more. Like, I always wanted to move out of Michigan and move to Florida because I love space. Going there and loving as much as I did down there and being with all my friends, it kind of opened that up. Like, I ended up...
All of your friends that you met through social media.
Yes, through social media. Yes. Ended up moving down there, and thanks to help from Flying Jenny and Apache Man, and actually I live with Herrera, or I always say it wrong, but Chris, who used to work on a social program, is enjoying retirement now. I ended up through social media, ended up with my roommate, which was freaking awesome, because he's freaking awesome.
Suck up.
Yeah. But it definitely played, I mean, just going from feeling like I was stuck in Michigan to seeing all the opportunities that meeting people through Twitter and doing all the awesome space units that I've done, like being a part of the Collect Space team for STS-133 and tweeting about that. Going to SpaceUp DC, like, I mean, just seeing how Twitter and social media helped things like SpaceUp, all the events, getting out there, bringing people from all over the country, these things. It just opened up a lot of different opportunities, and like as Chris Fred pointed out to me yesterday, the first time that we met at 132.
Yep.
But we really met at SpaceUp DC. So he claims that we're one of the good things of the SpaceUp program. Because that's his version of our kind of thing.
For the web audience.
Yes,
pointing off camera.
I pointed off camera to Dave, or as we're known now, Tave.
The other half of Tave, sitting over here.
The other half of Tave, who's sitting over there.
It should have been Tiffany. I like that.
Oh,
Tiffany.
Wait, what happened to Roger?
It's still Roger too, but.
Roger is half of Tabe. Someone is the other half of Tabe.
Yes! It makes so much more sense.
It's all obvious now.
Man, I must have slept through that class. Damn, I went to the wrong college.
You have to be a very attentive Twitter watcher to get all this.
And it helps if you're actually paying attention to the Space Vidcast as well, in the chat room.
Chat room, that's right.
It does.
But, work at some point, man.
I really didn't have like a structure for this entire talk, so I just like start rambling. But social media is like Twitter has definitely had a major impact on my life between meeting people, doing things I never thought I would do, like moving to Florida, and then moving to California a few months after moving to Florida, which I know there are a few people that are happy about and a few people that are sad about. But hey, we still go back to Florida for launches, so. But seeing how it's changed other people's lives too, it's just amazing how one form of media can do that much and how we can, like how, for instance, like SpaceUp is used to change how NASA is used to reach things like it speed ups, how it's just changed since the first speed up, and now it's like this, it's huge. And even like with the last endless barbecue, major.
I'd like to ask a quick question. Why is it the endless barbecue? I've seen a lot of reference to this on Twitter, and I don't know what it is.
I started at 1:34, if I'm correct, because I wasn't there for that one. But they just had a meeting, like a big barbecue after its launch. I think
what
it
happened
was
that we all went to Decepticon headquarters for a barbecue, and people were invited to bring supplies. And somebody apparently knows the Flintstones and brought over the largest slab of meat I've ever seen. And someone else clearly bruised or something because we had way too many supplies to get away. So then the next night, when we hadn't depleted everything, we were like, okay,
another
seriously,
barbecue.
Somebody eat and drink all of this stuff. And so a mess of us were still around, continued to get together the second night. And then by then, the joke was like, oh, this is like the endless barbecue, which of course, and
it went on for a few more days.
It did, and we just kept adding to the supply list.
And then
it actually moved. It wasn't always in the same place necessarily. And that kind of became the joke of whatever space tweets were in the area would just join in on the endless barbecue.
Yeah, and then for the 1:35 one, they brought stuff from like the condiments from 1:34 one, so it was kind of like it carried over.
Right,
and they did it for the Juno launch, and they're going to take a endless barbecue road trip now.
Oh my goodness.
Ancestral relish.
Which might make a stop in California.
Oh, cool.
Ooh. Do you find that affects your party-going behavior to be having a live webcast of the party?
It does affect some people. There were signs up for the 1:35 endless barbecue saying that, you know, you are on camera. And take note of that. However, in the same vein, the cameras were usually off in a corner, and they were the same webcams that they were these were the webcams. And they were kind of off in a back corner, and there was so much stuff going on. Clearly, there wasn't like other microphones, and nobody was, you know, had lapel mics or anything like that. So you probably couldn't hear Jack anything unless you were right next to the
camera anyway, or microphone, and actually say something. We didn't get a general gist of who was there, what was going on,
if somebody was running around naked, or, you know, drowning, or, you know,
tattooing, or...
These all sound fascinating,
but
yeah, this is,
how
am I missing out?
A range of party behavior I have not been
previously familiar with.
No, you're
right. You're missing out.
The tweet extension of Girls Gone Wild.
Wait, so how many people watch this on...
Yeah, who watches
it? Is it like three people, or...?
Well, you would be surprised, actually.
I would be.
The NSA, the CIA.
Voyeur, stalker.
A tweet-up who couldn't make it this time around were watching. People who were previously been to Emma's Barbecue who couldn't make it this time around were watching. People who want to just simply put a face to a name. You know, you tweet with a geek mom all the time because I'm sure you do.
All the time, I can't stop tweeting.
If you tweet and are in the space community, in the space tweet community, you have
tweeted with a geek
mom.
This is true. I have.
Sometimes you just want to say, okay, who is that person? Who is she? What does she look like? How does she sound? What does she do? you know, whatever, hi Shannon, whatever the case may be. And other times, you know, somebody's hoping that Tiffany will take her top off. So it's a lot of different reasons to watch, but at the same
time. Do you archive these things?
Yes. I was going to say Marianne, but speaking of myself in third person is just a little strange. But and then for other people, it would make no difference whatsoever whether it was or not, because some
like
people
like it.
Always on camera. So right. So it just kind of depends. But yeah, I mean, asking who's watching, it's everyone from the Australian creepers to the people who just simply want to participate because they can't.
Hi, Trent.
They don't have the time. Yes, absolutely. And there, I did hear rumors of people who had stated they were going to participate in the Endless Barbecue. It was clearly stated on the website that it would be webcast and that you really should watch yourself and that this is not an event for children. And there were people who were approached by superiors saying, we don't think it's a good idea for you to participate in.
Where did they?
FYI.
Really? Who? Mm-hmm. Where? What company? Where do they work? Are they even allowed to say?
Because it wasn't me, I don't feel comfortable disclosing necessarily, and because they were rumors as far as I'm concerned, so I don't know. But I'm sure that I previously worked for a major red box retail company, and I'm sure if my managers had seen or heard. And I didn't do anything out of what I feel to be out of the ordinary in my own personal life, but I can assure you if one of my managers had heard some of the things that I had said or saw some of the things that were going on in said barbecue, that I would have been recommended for it, absolutely. But I
guess I didn't watch long enough.
That brand.
Boring.
This makes it sound incredibly scandalous. I need to watch more of these.
It was a barbecue, but now it's on camera.
It was a bar. Yeah,
the whole publicity thing, once it's out on the web, you lost control of it.
Yep.
Some managers don't like that.
Right.
Cool.
Yeah. Welcome
to
the future.
We just have
something
we could have done. Yes.
Sure.
See,
sure.
We brought a full circle.
Yeah.
Exactly.
No, I went to a party, like a Burning Man type event, where there were nudists around. And, like, there are some photos people tagged me in, right? And I wasn't naked, but there are people in the distance who were.
Yeah.
And, like, and then people were like, whoa, what the hell is this? What's going on here?
Are you the nudie party?
There was a girl at the end of the barbecue who was wearing a very closely flesh-toned bikini. And I did get a couple tweets about her asking if she really was wearing anything. And I'm like, yeah, it's yellow. You can't see that. That would be why.
Hey,
what's that girl's name?
You gotta show
some
person.
Yes, you do. Down to the single
one
pieces here. Pretty much.
Like, get up. Yeah. That'd be a very weird thing.
No.
Imagine you're at a party. You're at a party and it pops up and so.
Anybody want to see Tiffany?
How it goes, man.
Anybody wants to see me?
Oh, man.
So you're the guy, no?
You should buff your boots before you do something like that.
You have to wonder, maybe there's just one creepy guy on the internet who's really fast.
Wow, I did not mean that. Here's the scenario I pictured.
Talking about losing control of the conversation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, being at a party and being like, on a webcast and having somebody ask for your number over that webcast.
Oh, that's...
Yes. But again, social media has changed the way that we interact with each other, right? When I was on, and I'm getting all different kinds of things, guys, I got it. When I first came to the very first SpaceUp, and we came to the first SpaceUp as Space Vacast in order to broadcast it out to the world, it failed miserably because less Wi-Fi than others do. But I had been in contact with Chris Radcliffe on and off for months and months and months, and via Twitter, and then eventually via email, never actually by phone. And so the first time that I met him in person was the day that I showed up for SpaceUp,
And he immediately, the very first thing he did was come up to me and give me a hug because we felt like we knew each other.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of actually when Tiffany gave this similar talk in SpaceUp DC, I made the mention that of all of the people in the room, the only person I knew before Twitter, like IRL, was my husband. Mm-hmm. And I can still say that for everybody here in this room even. But now, I mean, I know that I can call Tiffany and say, hey, I totally need a place to crash because yeah. I don't have whatever, and I know that she'll say yes. Like, there's no question in my mind. Actually, I think I have at some point.
Yeah.
And I feel that way about many, many a space tweet that I've met. I can't say that about all of my Twitter friends, but at least in the space community, I know I can walk up to pretty much any space tweet and ask them to help me with property balls, if I need a power supply.
Who's the resident meatball expert?
Who's a crack of meatballs?
Croc.
Like a croc pot, sorry.
Oh, I thought that was like a grouping of meatballs.
He is. He is a croc pot.
A pot of croc.
There you go.
Poppy cropper.
I can also pretty much guarantee if I pull out a tub of Legos, then space base will play with us.
Yes. So, how many people are watching right now? Do we know what the count is? I know I've asked this several times, but I think you're the person to ask.
It's very difficult to know for sure because I can tell you how many people are watching this pod right now on this server.
Oh, but there are different servers.
How many? How many are there?
I don't know because I don't care. You stream this.
Well, I guess while we're talking about social media, I should just shamelessly plug myself. I am on Twitter. It's at Molliway, MOLLIWAY, and I'm friendly, and I respond to people, usually, so.
When you have time.
When I have time.
And she has some really cool tweets, about once a week, I would say.
Usually.
All right, that's, I'll give you that right now.
That's not right.
These are like the totally awesome, off the wall, but makes you really think type tweets.
Well, actually, now I'm thinking, which ones are you qualifying in that category?
Oh, I would have to go back, actually.
All right, well.
It made me think of it, yeah.
Tweets that make you laugh and then make you think. I'm like being noble.
As somebody who neither tweets nor G pluses yet consistently at any level, can you discuss the difference between the two platforms aside from 120 characters?
We actually did this at the SpaceUp DC And I believe that the thing I said about it was. Well, at the time, it was just Facebook and Twitter was really what we were talking about. Facebook is for your old friends. Twitter is how you meet new friends.
Yeah.
Interesting enough, the reason why I'm in this industry at all and why everything happened in the last few years is because of Facebook. Because Robert Jacobson posted a space meetup on Buzz Aldrin's fan page. And I happened to be looking at Buzz Aldrin's fan page because I just read his book, and the meetup was the next day, and I met Molly and Mark Street at that, and now I'm moving to Mojave.
Yeah.
So what I'm trying to say is that Facebook ruined my life.
Yeah. Insanity is a pages.
The other thing about Twitter, not that you can't get Facebook updates to your phone because you can, but because they are so short and small, I think it's easier to ingest on your phone.
Yeah.
When you get a tweet under 140 characters or less?
I only do Twitter on my iPhone.
Mm-hmm.
I only do Facebook on my computer.
Yep.
That's why you're never on Facebook.
You never
have
put anything on Facebook that I
don't know. I'm always putting stuff on Facebook because I have a
Twitter. You have an automatic feed.
You're
right?
Just in the you're in
right.
The excluded group.
But
on
you
Facebook.
It's only tweets.
Yeah, there's pretty much only tweets. I don't actually do Facebook status updates.
So,
or if I put
like
some smart ass comment on one of his things,
yeah.
He occasionally responds to it.
Sounds like we should always make our own website. I guess Twitter's an easy way.
But mine is a dinosaur bottom.
Oh, I thought it was
like
a dinosaur arm
if you ever get shoulders around that.
Oh,
literally,
yeah.
Wait, I've got a dinosaur head right here.
First time reading
the girl. I'm reading the
Alex Lab Aerospike.
Well,
I mean,
Oh, really?
So this could be.
What's else got that idea from somebody?
The thermal loading.
Your head's gone.
Dinosaur with an arrow.
Travel the country.
Dino's bike.
Wow, that actually looks like a dinosaur.
Yeah. Okay, so now we need a train.
Yeah, train. Oh my god, we completed it.
Oh my god.
The original social media.
Face down for train.